Hey buddies, when you upgrade your Mac OS version of 10.11 Yosemite or most latest, but after that, you got the trouble to access your localhost Apache server. The tutorial shows you how to solve the problems. If you directly come to my tutorial, that's okay. Otherwise, if you have already taken someone's advice, and mess up your files, you have to take the following steps to get back the initial status. So now click the Finder, go up to the top menu bar, click Go tab, select Go to folder, enter /etc/ infill, and then click Go button. You will see your Apache 2 folder. Let me change the file previews and then click the folder. You will find a httpd.conf file. I have two, but hope won't make you confused. Suppose you will only have one. I made a mistake a long time ago, but anyway, check out the most updated one. If you really mess up with that, you have to do the next step. Actually, Apple has already helped you back up your file to the directory name called original. When you click in, you will find another httpd.conf file that's already saved before you upgrade. I hope you have never touched this one. The easy way is drop it out to Apache 2 directory and then click Authenticate tab. The pop-up message box comes up. Let me drop it in the middle to show you clearly. Click Replace tab to replace the file contents. You need to enter your PC user password to confirm the action and then click OK. Since OS X Mavericks, we must use CLI to access Apache. So now we must use the terminal to reload the Apache servers for every single change. Go to Finder, select Applications, and then scroll down. You can see Utilities. Click in. You will find the terminal. You can drop it out to your Launchpad SMS me if you didn't have one. But I have already done it, so that's okay. Let me close this. And then click to open the terminal. Type the common syntax is very easy. Sudo, that means super user do, Apache, ctl, this is L, and make a space, and then type restart, that to reload the Apache servers, and then hit enter. We need to enter PC user password to make confirm change, and then hit enter again. Go to your browsers at the top menu bar, click the history tab, select Clean Recent History and the time range to clean the history cache to avoid any issues. And then type localhost at the search bar. Refresh the browser again. Mostly you will see it works. That means you success access to your localhost. If not, you still got error 404. If you've done all the steps and also cleaned the browser's history cache, but still couldn't access to your localhost, that's probably because your server's version has been upgraded. So back to terminal. Type httpd:// hit enter to check out the Apache server's version. If it is 2.4 or the number higher to latest version, that's the reason why happens error 404 because the version has been changed. Follow the step to figure out the problems. We will use this one is command line interface CLI through the terminal to make change. When you use the terminal, type sudo nano. That means gonna to change the file content. Sudo nano, make space between and then directory path. /etc/apache2/h4/httpd-npm.con. Make sure the path correct and then hit enter again. You will see the file contents. Scroll down to find the log file line. Put a hash at the begin to disable SF log, and then plus Ctrl X to request exit. Enter Y to save file and then hit enter again to exit. Remember, no matter you use which method, you must reload your Apache servers for every single change by using terminal. Type sudo /apache-ctl/restart and hit enter. And go to your browser, again, clean the history cache to prevent any old page issues, and refresh the browser. If you saw it works, that means you access to localhost. How do you know you really access and run your localhost server? Back to your terminal. Type sudo space apache ctl space stop. Hit enter. Go refresh browser. Now you will see the page is error 404 because you have already stopped your server and unable access to your localhost. Back to terminal, now type sudo space apache ctl space start. Hit enter. Refresh the browser. Now the page shows it works. Either if you type localhost IP, still works. Now you probably will get another trouble when you try to access the directory. You will get error 403, even access to phpMyAdmin. Mostly error 403 means you don't have the permission to access file or directory on this server. For this, you may try to give all directories permission, but maybe not such at all. I could access my php.ini file to my browser, but the directories. It's so ridiculous of the Apache server setting. That's maybe not exactly only permission of the directories. Like I said before, because Apple's lousy change to make directory list visible. For this issue, only way give you 403 error for unable accessing. You don't have to make all index pages for each directory because we need to see the directory list, right? And no need to set up any virtual host for now until we fix up localhost connection because it's not the point. The thing we need to do is make the directory to be available. When you use the terminal, type the command line sudo space nano, the directory path, /etc/apache2/httpd.con, and then hit enter. Enter your PC user password and then hit enter again. Follow the procedures that make a little faster. Scroll down to load module. First, uncomment module PHP 5 this line. We have to uncomment that, otherwise we can't access any PHP file or phpMyAdmin as well. So delete the hash at the beginning. Second, scroll down a little bit to directory section. First of all, let me change none at allow override. Reminders, since Apache 2.4 have changed the configuration, make sure use require or granted or deline, depends on what you set. Require instead of order, allow from or, so on, so on. Make sure use upgraded syntax as require or something. My is granted, and then scroll down more. Third, make sure your document root and directory path, which your localhost is pointing at. I don't know yours. You may use any kinds of server. Same concept to find your document root path URL. I set my own Apache servers on Mac. If I put any files into documents directory, it will displace all at my localhost browser. So make sure the path correct. Fourth, at options line, you have to add indexes in the syntax. That's very important part. Let me show you Apache syntax description. If a URL which maps to a directory is requested and there's no directory index, for example, index.html in that directory, then mode auto index will return a formatted listing of the directory. That's what we want to show the directory list. Scroll down more, make sure my syntax require or is correct if you are using Apache 2.4 or latest version. And then hit Ctrl X to request exit. Enter Y to save file, and then hit Enter again to exit. No matter either way you use at the save file, remember we load your Apache servers. In the terminal again, type sudo space apache ctl hit space restart and hit enter again. Go to refresh browser. You can see now I access to phpMyAdmin in my localhost or other directory that's my site work with showing the directory list.
Hope I could help you get over this trouble. You can visit my webpage to get more details.